Hi there, Danica here. And in this video, I'm just gonna quickly show you this table that I created using JetEngine. This table, what we needed for this project is we need to know where is the members are, like their current progress, which part of the course. So this setup, they are using LearnDash and they have different modules inside the course, and they are also using Memberium for Keap. So they're trying to email or notify this member regarding their latest progress and where they're at. Like example, if the member is currently in module 3, when they have, like that's their last activity, then the client want to contact that member and tell them regarding their current status and to encourage them to continue. So we decided to use the table from JetEngine and created a query for that one. I'm gonna show you how I set it up though. I'm gonna blur private data here, but let me show you what we have. So on the back end, we created the table. First is you need to create a query before you create a table. So this is the current query that we have. So we want to pull. So let me just zoom in a bit so it's much bigger. But we want to pull the lessons that members are in but they haven't completed yet. So if first, before we dive into the query, if we check the database for LearnDash, the table that is in, we're using the LearnDash user activity for this. And the way this works is, as you can see, it is attached to a post ID, a course ID, and then user ID, and then activity status. It's either 1 or 0. 1 means they have completed that certain activity. And then they also have some timestamp here for the when they started, completed, and even updated. So what I need is the activity status column and then the activity started. So that's what I'm basing this from. So in my query here, I have a query. I pull the SQL query type, and then the from table is the LearnDash user activity. So in here, as you can see, we have a from table is the LearnDash user activity. And then I decided that I need to call another table and join that here. So what I have is the LearnDash user activity and then the LearnDash user activity meta. So I connected the two. So other than the user activity meta, I also called the users table because I wanna make sure it matches the user ID. And then I also have the user meta, user ID. So here in our query, the first rule is I need this to be in a specific course because the client, what they want is pull the data from a specific course only. So I pulled that from a specific course. I grabbed the course ID of that LearnDash. Next is activity type is equal to lesson. So as you can see, this is the activity type. It's lesson. And then activity started, it must be greater than 0 because this is a timestamp. So it must be greater than 0. That means they're currently in progress for that lesson. And then the activity status, it must be 0. So 0 means they haven't completed it yet, and it will turn to 1 once they have completed that. And then I also make sure that I'm only gonna pull the subscriber in the reporting. So that's my rule here. I'm just gonna scroll down so that you could see what else I have set up. Okay, so let's check and test this table. Before that, after you create the query, you need to then create the table. So in my table here, I pull that query that I created, and then the columns, it will allow you to pull that data that your query has been using. So in here, I set it to row value, post term, and then I called that specific field. I also customized the column output in some of this area, and so on here. So I'm just going to open this so that you could follow. And then save. So now, if I search, so example, I need the list of user who are in progress for, let's just say, module 1, and I need to include a colon here. So these are the current, so out of 149, we have 69 contacts who are enrolled to the Talking Toxins course, and then they're currently in module 1. So this is the list. So what the client will do is they will download this and import it in their Keap account, tag them with specific tag, and then follow up with them via email under the funnels or campaigns that they have set up. Okay, so now let's check some of this member. I'm going to grab this email and then paste that here. And we are in module 1. So if we check, so this member has the Talking Toxins tag, as you can see, but then they haven't started on anything or have a LearnDash progress on the back end for that course. So I'm not sure why is that, but on the table, that is where the last or the latest progress of that member. So I'm gonna need to check with the client why for this module 1 members I could not see it on the back end, because we just imported that data from their website. So maybe what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch to testing in module 2, and then I'm gonna copy this. Let's do another search. So here we have Talking Toxins, and the progress is they are in module 2 because module 1 is already complete. So this means the module 1 that we have in here, they are in the course, but they haven't done anything for that module yet. That's why. But for the module 2, you can see in their example that it's correct that this member is currently in module 2. I think the LearnDash lesson here may not be protected properly. I need to check. So far it is closed and it did have the required ID. But I need to check why it is not listed on the user's data. Some of them, especially the module 1 list that we have. But if we try another one, module 3. So you can see that this member is in module 3, which is correct. This table, we did it so that we can follow up on those members. But in the update that we also did for this website is we are applying a completed tag each time they complete a certain module, which will be very handy as well in Keap's automation. But the current right now, that's why we also needed to create this table, is some members did not mark the modules complete, even if they have completed all of the topics inside, but still they haven't marked it complete. So it doesn't show when we exported it via the one. The first table that we did was completed. Well, like who have completed the modules, but then the client said that a lot of the members has also like completed the module, but they just haven't marked it off. So we just decided to create another reporting and do it this way, because the purpose for them is to follow up on their members. So this is just an example of how you can take advantage of the JetEngine's table. You could pull a very custom and specific query that you need for your purpose or whatever use cases that you need it to for your project. So I hope this example helps. If you have any question regarding this, please comment it down below. I'll do my best to get back to you, but as you have noticed, been busy for a while recording these videos, but really appreciate your support. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.